I am Humaira Arshad with lecture in formal methods of software engineering. In previous lecture we learn about Z specification and refinements. In previous lecture we learn about what is scheduler. Then we learn about Z specification. IDs. After that we learn abstract state and initializations. All this topic we have covered in previous lecture. Today we learn about operations and their specifications. Start our today lecture. Today we learn about operations, what is operations, their steps and their specifications. In which we see first point is create. We learn what is meant by create. Create is a process which add a process to the set of ready process. In operations, first point is create, in which add a process to the set of ready processes. And then second point is dispatch. What is meant by dispatch? Dispatch takes one of the ready processes and put into the processor. Third one is timeout, which take processor running on the CPU, that is current processor. Remove it from the processor and return it to the set of ready processes. It's very important. And this lecture, listen very carefully. We learn about operations and their specifications. We learn about create, dispatch, and timeouts. Next one, our point is block. Blocks which remove the current process from the processors and adds it to the set of block processes. I repeat this point. Which remove the current process from the processor and adds it to the set of block processes. Next operation is wake up. Takes a block process, move it into the set of ready processes. And in the last we have destroy. What is meant by destroy? Which terminates a process is called destroy. In simple word, destroy means terminate a process. So these operations are the typical operations that schedule work performs. We learn creating, dispatch, timeout, block, wake up, and destroy. Creating a process, that means adding process to the ready list. Dispatch, taking a process from the ready list and put it on the CPU. Third one, we learn timeout. When time slot runs out, it take it from the CPU and put it back to the ready queue. And then we learn wake up. Wake up means IOs were complete. And finally terminate our process. That means in particular case the process does not need the CPU anymore. It has completed its work and hence it needs to be terminated. I hope you understood that all points, all operations, it's very important and necessary. Now we are going to specifying all these different operations. Number one operation is create. In which slides also describe the describes operation that we learn create, dispatch, timeout, block, wake up and destroy. And then we have a first operation that is create. We learn the specification of create. We have create a create. If you see a create, which is data a scheduler, it's change the scheduler. We have the output as PIDs. We have output as PIDs. P is indicate PIDs and preconditions. Next one is free not equal empty. Free is not empty, so we can assign PIDs to the this new process that is coming. Then current. New current equal to current. This one indicate, this dash indicate new current. New current equal to the current. This is, we are not change the state of the current. If there is process on the which has CPU, it will remain the same there. The ready now has its new process that has just come, which has been assigned our new PIDs. And then we have a block. Block remain the same. And then free has this P. This P take out of the free list, free set, and the new free is. And the new free is this old free minus from this current P that is assigned, and this P that has been assigned should be a member of free set. I repeat this point. Block remains same. Then we move free, new free. Free has P, this one P. Take out this free list or free set, and the new free is this old free minus from the element P that is assigned, and this P that has been assigned should be member of free set. So in this particular case, what is happening? When we need to create a new process and we need to put it to the ready queue, first thing that we need to do is we need to assign a PID to the process. Then we need to check whether we have available PID in our preset. So if there is no PID is available, that means we cannot have any new process. We have all the process already been assigned, cannot have new one. So this is free precondition. Then the rest is very very simple. Only things that we will do is we change, take one element from the free set, that is the PID that we assign to this new process, and then That new process is put into the ready queue. It's difficult, but if you listen very carefully, then you will understand what is meant by free current, ready block, and free and current PID. I will repeat all this process again. First of all, we need to assign a PID to the processes. Okay, we assign PID to process. Then next step is we need to check whether we have available PID in our preset. So if there is no PID is available, that means we cannot have any new process. We have all the process already been assigned, cannot have new one. So this is precondition. Then the rest is very simple. Only things that we need to do is we change, take one element from the preset, that is the PID that we assign to this new process, and then that new process is put into the ready queue. So the set of ready processes change, as well as our set contained pre-PID also change. The rest remain the same, nothing else change. Current is current was, waiting set has the same. So the two set are the change in this slide, in this operations. Only two things change. Number one is ready, and the free set. Other operations in this slide remain same. Two operations will change. Number one is ready and number two is free. Rest remain the same. And I hope you clear all this point. Now we look at the specification of the dispatcher. If we see previous slide, in which we see first operation is create and second one is dispatch, and now here we see the dispatcher specification of dispatcher. What does dispatch do? Dispatch take one element from the ready set and assign to the CPU. So it's change the current. First question is, what does dispatcher do? Dispatch take one element from the ready set and assign to the CPU. So it change the current. So in which we see dispatch change the scheduler. It is PID is the output. Current is equal to the null PID, nothing on the CPU. Current is equal to null PID, which means nothing on the CPU. Next one is ready. Ready is not empty. There is nothing that can be scheduled. There is nothing that can be scheduled. And then we have a new current. In previous slide, I also says that this dash indicates new one. Okay, this is a new current, is a member of the ready. We take one element from the ready, and that will assign to the current, and that is what we get. After that, what we get? Ready is not modified. New ready set equal to the old ready set. This one, if we see here, we see new current equal to the ready. Then we see new ready equal to the ready. There is nothing change. New ready is equal to the old ready. Also minus from this element current. And then remain same, new ready is equal to the old ready. Next we see block does not change, it remains same, new block equal to the block. free does not change and the output is that element current which has been dispatched. So there is nothing difficult in that specification. In previous lecture we learned about initialization and abstraction. Initialization and dispatch is straightforward specification. Let us look at the rest of specification. Now we have, if we see previous slide, next operation is timeout. This one is timeout. Now we have timeout. Once again, it changed the scheduler. Delta A scheduler means that once again it changed the scheduler. At the output is PIDs. Current is not equal to null PID, that is CPU has been occupied, some processes has it. The new state of current when the process timeout, new state will be null PID. New state will be null PID. Next one is ready set. Ready set get that new element occupied by a CPU. So it has been appended. It's take one more element, that is current. I will repeat. Now I am repeating this point. The new state of current when the process time out, new state will be null PID. After that, ready set get that new element occupied by CPU, so it has been appended. It take one more element only. Next one is blocked. Block does not change. Free does not change and output is current PID. So in timeout, in this particular case, once again you see the specification is straightforward manner. In previous slide we learn about create and then we see dispatcher, and now we learn about the timeout. There is nothing specific change between create, dispatch and timeout, and other remaining are the remain same. Also you see the specification is straightforward manner. There is nothing specific about it. In this particular case we see, in particular case we learn when time is out, we set current equal to the null and then take current and put it into the ready queue. The rest state does not change. Now I repeat this point. In this particular case we learn when time is out, we set current equal to the null and then take current and put it into the ready queue. The rest state does not change. I hope you understood these three operations, creation, dispatcher and timeout. Now look at the remaining couple of specifications. We learn about block. A block which is similar, in this particular case it changed the scheduler. Current is equal to null PID. Current become null PID. Ready remain ready, does not change. We take current and put into the block cell. Block has one more entry, in which we say block has one more entry, that is current, and then we take the union between block and current. Free does not change and output is current. Free does not change and output is current. Block specification is similar to the timeout. we learn in previously we learn timeout, and we says that a block is similar to the timeout specification. The only difference is this particular case is we instead of put the current process into the ready queue, which was the case in the previous specification. In previous specification, what we does? In previous specification, we put the current process into the ready queue, which was the previous specification. We put this process into the block queue. Difference is that in timeout, we put the current process into the ready queue, and in block specification, we put this process into the block queue. Nothing else changed. Rest is remain same. And I hope you understood the difference between timeout and block, and also previous operations. Now look at the rest. We have the specification wake up. In this slide, we learn about wake up operation. We have the specification of a wake up. It changed the scheduler. Number one, data scheduler means that it changed the scheduler once again. Output is PID. So this time we say we need to wake up particular process. I will repeat this point. We say we need to wake up particular process with this particular PIDs. The first precondition is requirement. This input is a member of the block set. This input is member of block set. That is the process that need to be taken from the block queue and put into the ready queue. Block set put into the ready set and has to be present into the block set. Current does not change. Also, in which particular operation, that is wake up, in which new current equal to the current and new ready equal to the ready and take a union with PID, and current does not change. Now since we take from the blocked queue, and put into the ready queue. In this particular case, we change the set accordingly. So we take this element from the block set. So the new value of the block will be old value, locked value. This element take from the block set. This element take from the block set. The new value of the block will be old value. The old set minus the element P and ready will be updated. So in this case, new value of the ready queue equal to the old value. Ready set union with P and free does not change. Now here once again nothing specifically changing occur. Same specification we see in many cases, in previous many cases. And I hope you understood that all operations. And last one is destroy, which means dare to terminate the overall process. Now summarize our today lecture. We learn about operations and all specification of the all these operations. Number one is create. We learn creating a process, adding something to the ready processes, and then we learn about dispatch. Dispatch mean that ready processes to the processor, put ready processes to the processor. And then timeout means that removing process from the processor and returning its set of ready processes. After that we learn about block. Block means that removing it from the processor and adding it to the set of block process. And after that we learn about wake up block process, moving it into the set of ready processes. And in the last we learn about destroy. Destroy means that terminate a process. After that we learn about the specification of creation, create, operation, dispatcher, and in this slide we learn about timeout specification, block specification, and also wake up and destroy specification. And I hope you understood that all lecture, and if you have any query then you ask me. Thank you.